Hello everyone. Today I'm going to make a very basic t-shirt design, because most of the time I see that people try to make a very vectorized work, but the design, a good design is actually the message you are giving. So I'm going to make a design with just this text. This is a text from one of my order. So I like to get high. This is a text for like a rock climbing kind of t-shirt design. So that's why I want to make a design with this. And for this kind of designs, we need some images like this. Like this is a rock climbing image I can see here. I am going to use this one. Now this image can be copyrighted, but I am not going to use this image as in my design, any part of my design. I am going to take that image and create a silhouette image of that. So here I am using a software called paint.net. You will find this free on its official website. You can download it. So I am just going to make a silhouette image from here, and the easiest way is go to effect, then use multi-threshold. If you cannot find this multi-threshold option, you can check my Facebook group for the link. Or you can just search on Google like paint.net effect, you will easily get them. So if I increase or decrease the amount here, you can see it is increasing or decreasing the amount of details in my image. Like if I want to keep some areas in my vector, I can keep it like this. But for this one, I am going to use a complete silhouette image like this, just like this, then press OK. This is going to give me a black silhouette like that. And for some quality reasons, I am going to make it higher in size. So something like 1500 pixel this image is right now. Now I am pressing Ctrl A and Ctrl C to copy. I want to take this image inside my Illustrator. So something like that. I am pasting it here. So if I go to image trace and then silhouettes, you can see it is going to make me a silhouette image like this, and this is now in complete vector format. So this part I don't need. This is the part of my image right now, and it is in complete vector format. Now if you want a highly detailed vector, you can just take that image and draw with your paint tool whatever you feel good. So the plan is here to make a simple clean looking design, but giving this kind of climbing message here. So I'm going to use a kind of bold font for this one here. I like to get high, so something like Norwester. This font is a good font, it is long and bold. Or maybe something like, I don't know which font will look good. I have a font called Impact. This is also a bold looking font, something like this. Maybe like Academic M54. Whatever font you have, you can just make this design with that font. It is not about the text. I'm going to represent the message here. Now for this high text, I want to use something like a scripted font. So I'm using this Bonbon bold font. You can find this font on Google also. And the specialty of this font is, you can, like if I select this text, I am pressing Shift T for Task Type tool, or you can go to here, Task Type tool, and with Task Type tool we can click on any letter we want. We can select each and every letter and then we can modify that letter. So I am selecting this H here, and if I go to this Glyphs panel, if you don't have that option open, you go to Window, then Type, you need to activate this option, this Glyphs. Then on this Glyphs option, you will find something like a lots of variation of this font. It has to be an open type font, then you will get these options. Like you can see, this is the alternatives of these fonts. So not every font support this kind of alternatives, but some font supports. So this is one of that kind of font. So I'm searching for something like a alternative for my H here. So maybe this H will work. If I double click on it, it is going to add this option to my text, just like that. Then I am selecting this H here. You have seen me doing this in my different videos, I hope. So I am going to just making it look like something like this, or maybe for this G here. If I select my G, I can change my G also. Now for G, it is actually not every font have some good looking alternative. Sometimes some font doesn't look good. So this is, I think, okay, maybe I can just bring that a bit down, just a little bit down, to make this area visible, this source of the H visible through my G, something like that. So the point of my this video is I am going to make it look like this option, this text here. I am going to use my this vector, something like that, and for that I need to place it like this. So I am just representing the climbing kind of effect here with basic vector and basic text, not any kind of fancy styles. So first step is I am selecting my text, right click and break them. Now they are acting as a text right now, sorry, acting as a shape right now, not a text. So first step is I am going to align them with this side together, and I am selecting this one with my this high text to align it with the right side of my text. Now I can bring them a bit down to make an area like this, or I can just simply overlap my text here just a bit. So this source of the H is overlapping my T here, so I need to make it look good. So I'm selecting the high text, go to object path and then offset path, of course. Now 10 pixel is looking good, maybe a bit smaller, 7 pixel, that's good. Cut. Now I want to select my this text because I want to create that transparency effect. So press Ctrl F for paste in front. Now it is looking like this. So that part is good. I want to do something for this area. So if I double click, I can individually select each and every text here, these shapes here. So the plan is this part of the G will be behind and the H will be come from this area, but it will stay behind this part of the G and then on top of the G. So it may sound confusing. Let's select that, go to path and then offset path, of course. Okay, I'm turning on the preview to see if this is good or bigger, maybe a bit bigger. So 5 pixel is good. Let's cut. Now I want to create that effect with my G, so I'm selecting my G, double click, open, press Ctrl F. So as you can see, we pasted that inside the transparency and it is looking like this. Now this part of the G, this area should be on top of this line. So I need to select this one, then press Shift E for eraser tool. Now I am erasing this part because I don't want that to be on top. But I am not erasing anything from here because that should be there. So it is looking like this. Click here. Now I am selecting my G again. Go to object path. Same repeating process, just like this one. Okay, then cut. Now this time I am going to paste it inside the, paste it on the H here. So if I open the transparency of the H, press Ctrl F, paste in front. So as you can see, this area is looking good, but not this area. So press Shift E for eraser tool. Now I am erasing this part, just like this. And as you can see, this is how it is looking like. This H is behind this area, but on top of this area. So that is the effect I wanted to create here. So that is good. And for this area here, as you can see, this is how it is looking right now. I can keep it as it is, like, or I can just make it overlap my H text just a bit, something like this. That is good. Now I want to, now my this vector is selected, so I'm going to object path and then offset path to create a offset path. Same 5 pixel is good. Click OK. Now cut. Okay, so this part where the vector is overlapping my text, I want this part to be visible. But this area, I want to, like, it should combine with my this graphic area. So we will do that later. So first step is I am selecting this is high text group. Open the transparency, press Ctrl F to paste in front. Now as you can see, this area is looking good. This is overlapping area. And this part is not looking good, I want to hide that. So I am pressing N for my pencil tool. Make sure that your foreground color is, your fill color is black. So if I draw a shape here, it will be hidden. So it is looking like this. But this area is not looking very good. You can see this is a looking like something weird. So I am selecting the shape here, then press Shift E for eraser tool. Now I want to erase this part that is overlapping there. Just like this, that is good. Now click here. Now as you can see, so this part should not be look like this. I can simply keep this edge on top of this part, as this part the vector is on top of my text, and for this part I can keep the edge on top. So when we created a offset path for my this high text that we pasted inside the I like to get text. So if I select this one inside the transparency, I will find that shapes. So I want only this edge shape. So if I select it, Ctrl C, then click here, then select the vector here, open the transparency, then press Ctrl F. Now as you can see, this is how it is looking, but these areas are not looking very good. But I wanted to just create this effect for this area only, not these areas. So I am pressing Shift E for eraser tool again. Press Alt and just make it like that. Erase these parts, or maybe of course these parts also. Something like that. Because I want to just create that effect for this small area. So it is looking like that, no problem. If I click here, this part is visible. Now if this is an important part of your graphic, you can keep it. But for my this design here, this is not very important part. So I am selecting the vector here, then press Ctrl E for eraser. I am erasing this part because that I don't want. Something like this, and that is looking good. So this is the final design for my this video, guys. Now this is not important to create something like a very premium vector. You must have a Freepik premium account or something like that. No, if you just can deliver a good message with a good graphic, with an average graphic, you can make a good design. Now if you think like this is not a very good looking design, but if you are a rock climber or something like this, mountain climber, this message will attract you. Like I like to get high, and then I am using a climber silhouette image here to represent the message here. Okay guys, so we can just keep it as it is, or we can just create a, I have another idea that I can simply create a box kind of shape here, just to keep everything inside a box area. Then if I press Shift X, it will convert into a stroke. Now if I make it bigger like this, something that is good, I can simply bring that down like this, sorry, bring that up. This part also I can bring that closer to my text. Just like this, then of course I can make it something like this, and for this area also. Okay, so the easiest way is if I select everything, then press Shift and click on my rectangle, it is going to deselect my rectangle, and everything else is now selected. Now if I make them a group, I can then again select everything, then align them with my, align them like center wise. Like this option, horizontal, and I want to keep this foot, like this part of the climber, out of the box. So if I select this high text, it is now grouped, so I need to double click to select it. Then inside the transparency, I will find this vector pack. This vector offset path that we created, I am going to copy this, that is good. Now I am clicking here. Now I need to select my this rectangle. Then open the transparency, press Ctrl F to paste in front, and as you can see, it is making this cutout effect from this area. And that is, if that is like smaller, you can go to object path, offset path again, to make a create a bigger offset path like this, then click here. So this is the final graphic, guys, and this was just to show you how you can easily create a vector from an image and then create a very basic kind of typography style design but with a premium vector look. So that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this one and learned something new from this. Thank you, everyone. See you in the next video, guys. Have a great time.